In this video, we will explore the role of DNA polymerases, which are known as DNA polymerase 3 in bacteria and as DNA polymerases delta and epsilon in mammals. Both prokaryotic and eukaryotic DNA polymerases possess what are referred to as core enzymes. These core enzymes are crucial because they catalyze the formation of the 5' to 3' phosphodiester linkages, perform proofreading activities, and have three essential substrates. The first substrate is the parent single strand, which acts as a template. The second substrate is the primer, which anneals to the template and initiates DNA replication. The third substrate is the deoxyribonucleotide, which matches the nucleotide read on the template. It is important to note that the core enzymes of prokaryotic and eukaryotic DNA polymerases have different compositions. The prokaryotic DNA polymerase 3 consists of several subunits, including the alpha subunit responsible for polymerization, the epsilon subunit with 3' exonuclease activity, and the theta subunit, which activates the alpha subunit. In contrast, eukaryotic DNA polymerase delta contains a single subunit, P125 or pol delta 1, which has both catalytic and 3' exonuclease activities. Additionally, it includes other subunits such as P50, P66, and P12, which all contribute to forming the hollow enzyme. The hollow enzyme is the complete enzyme complex and includes the core enzyme and auxiliary proteins necessary for efficient DNA polymerization. The catalytic site of most enzymes typically accepts only a single substrate, but the catalytic site of DNA polymerase must accommodate four different deoxyribonucleotides: DATP, DGTP, DCTP, and DTTP. The selectivity of the active site must be low enough to accommodate these four different substrates, but high enough to correctly match each deoxyribonucleotide to its complementary nucleotide on the template strand. Replication fidelity is determined by two key processes. The first process, kinetic proofreading, is based on the specific properties of the catalytic site. This ensures that the correct nucleotide is added by favoring the correct pairing energetically and spatially. The second process, exonuclease proofreading, depends on a specific domain or activity of the polymerase that can remove incorrectly paired nucleotides and ensure high fidelity during DNA replication. These mechanisms together ensure that DNA replication is both efficient and accurate, minimizing errors in the newly synthesized DNA strand. Let's examine the catalytic site of DNA polymerase. The catalytic site of DNA polymerase does not recognize a single deoxyribonucleotide, but instead recognizes a base pair. At this stage, the template strand extends with a guanine, G, at the end, while the growing strand has a cytosine, C, complementary to it. The next nucleotide in the template strand is adenine, A, which will determine the incoming nucleotide. Base pairing occurs between the template strand and the incoming nucleotide. Here, the adenine, A, on the template strand guides the selection of the incoming deoxyribonucleotide, which is thymine, T. The incoming thymine, in its triphosphate form, DTTP, is positioned within the catalytic site, ready to form a new bond. The active site of DNA polymerase ensures precise base pairing by aligning the incoming deoxythymidine triphosphate with the template strand's adenine, A. The 5' alpha phosphate of DTTP is positioned near the 3' hydroxyl of the last incorporated nucleotide in the growing DNA strand. The geometry of correctly paired nucleotides is critical for accurate DNA synthesis. Here, the AT base pair and the previously formed GC base pair show nearly identical structural configurations. This similarity allows any of the four deoxyribonucleotides to be accepted as long as they match the template strand. Phosphodiester bond formation occurs when the 3' hydroxyl of the growing DNA strand attacks the alpha phosphate of DTTP. This reaction links the incoming T nucleotide to the chain, releasing pyrophosphate, PPI, as a byproduct. The DNA strand extends as the thymine, T, is now incorporated, forming a stable base pair with adenine, A, on the template strand. The DNA polymerase catalytic site is now ready to accommodate the next incoming nucleotide. The catalytic site structure of DNA polymerase is designed so that when base pairing is correct, the positioning of the incoming deoxyribonucleotide is perfectly aligned for bond formation. However, in the case of a mismatch, such as adenine A attempting to pair with another adenine A, the lack of hydrogen bond formation results in improper positioning. The error rate in this process is primarily determined by the kinetics of the reaction, hence the term kinetic proofreading. The formation rate of the phosphodiester linkage with a correct base pair is 10,000 times faster than with an incorrect base pair, which significantly reduces the likelihood of errors during DNA replication. This kinetic difference ensures that the DNA polymerase selectively incorporates the correct deoxyribonucleotides, maintaining high fidelity in DNA synthesis. Deoxyribonucleotides and ribonucleotides share a similar structure, with the main distinction being the presence of a hydroxyl group in ribonucleotides. However, the high concentration of ribonucleotides, 10 times greater than that of deoxyribonucleotides, poses a significant risk of misincorporation during DNA synthesis. The main difference between these building blocks lies in the sugar component of the nucleotides, ribose in RNA and deoxyribose in DNA. In deoxyribose, hydrogen replaces the hydroxyl group bound to the 2' carbon of ribose. When an incoming deoxyribonucleotide binds to the catalytic site of DNA polymerase, the hydroxyl group on its 3' carbon fits neatly into a binding pocket. This correct positioning is aided by discriminator amino acids that form van der Waals contacts with the deoxyribose. However, ribonucleotides are partially excluded from the DNA polymerase catalytic site due to the presence of an OH group on C2' of the ribose. This hydroxyl group prevents the insertion of the OH on C3' into the binding pocket, causing the ribose to shift away from the discriminator amino acids. As a result, ribonucleotides are not properly positioned in the active site, making the formation of a phosphodiester bond and the misincorporation of a ribonucleotide highly unlikely. DNA polymerase accuracy also depends on an exonuclease activity. Binding the wrong deoxynucleotide to the active site is not the only source of misincorporation. It's also possible to bind the wrong form of a deoxynucleotide. Deoxynucleotides can exist in alternative forms called tautomers. These tautomeric forms can produce base pair mismatches. For example, consider keto and enol guanine. In the keto form, guanine has a carbonyl group on carbon 6 that can form a hydrogen bond with the NH group on carbon 4 of cytosine, which results in the correct GC pairing. In the enol form, guanine has a hydroxyl group on carbon 6, which allows it to form a hydrogen bond with the carbonyl group on carbon 4 of thymine. This leads to a TG mismatch. If a tautomeric nucleotide is incorporated, the exonuclease activity of DNA polymerase corrects this misincorporation. This exonuclease activity ensures high fidelity in DNA replication by removing incorrectly paired nucleotides. The double helix distortion caused by a base pair mismatch triggers a conformational change of the DNA polymerase. This results in a shift in the position of the thumb domain and a movement of the elongating strand by approximately 41 angstroms, which causes it to exit the catalytic site and enter the exonuclease domain. In the exonuclease domain, the mismatched nucleotides are removed. After removal, another conformational change brings the elongating strand back into the catalytic site of the enzyme, which allows DNA synthesis to resume. This process ensures that errors in DNA replication are minimized, maintaining the integrity of the genetic information passed on during cell division. So, how does the polymerase detect this misincorporation? In eukaryotes, polymerases delta and epsilon are responsible for the duplication of the genome and contain several domains. In prokaryotic DNA polymerase, the exonuclease activity is carried out by separate subunits called the epsilon subunits. The catalytic site is located between the palm and finger domains, and a separate domain is responsible for the exonuclease activity. DNA polymerases delta and epsilon play crucial roles in chromosome replication, ensuring high fidelity during DNA synthesis. They possess a highly specific 3' exonuclease domain that enables them to remove incorrectly incorporated nucleotides and thereby enhance the accuracy of replication. Additionally, these polymerases recognize the minor groove of the DNA helix and probe the base pairing of newly formed base pairs, which allows them to detect and correct mismatches effectively. In conclusion, the survival of organisms and the rate of cell division depend heavily on the fast and accurate replication of DNA. The accuracy of this replication is determined by the specificity of the DNA polymerase. In prokaryotes, the epsilon subunit of DNA polymerase 3 is responsible for proofreading activity. In eukaryotic DNA polymerases delta and epsilon, built-in exonuclease activity ensures high fidelity during DNA replication.